since I'm an awesome developer, I realize that that's the same thing, just a different word. So I'm going to reuse it. And I think you just start going down that path, and it's so easy to go so far.
Right.
So if you can keep them at this higher level, wherever I was back here somewhere, this higher level, and you do have to reuse some, like you're going to have some duplication and a lot of stuff, but the scenarios end up so much better. So I always err on the side of having better scenarios than less duplication in my test automation stuff. Does that answer your question?
Yeah, I mean, it seems like it's kind of a fine line.
Oh, sure. It's going to, like I said, I was doing this for like a year and a half the wrong way, five different wrong ways. And so I think I finally kind of sort of got it, but.
So you're keeping those at the higher level, which really describes the very beginning, but you are building some tests that are more specific that actually.
Right. So because these tend to be slower, and because, like, if I stick to the thing, if I say from a extreme programming perspective, XP says I should have a 10-minute build, that's like a, you know, good. I want to be able to make a production change and in 10 minutes know that the system is working. So the only way I can do that is have a whole bunch of unit tests and have some of these.
Okay.
So I probably, like the project I was explaining before, I probably had 90% behavior tests and 10% unit tests. And that's when I got to like an hour-long build process. And now I try and shoot for maybe 5 or 10% of tests like this, and the rest of it be unit tests. And like I was saying before, I try and write my unit tests in a more behavior way, so that if you were to print them all out, you can read them and get a similar thing, although it's not as nice looking. Yeah.
Is class still going on? Or?
Yeah, we're almost done.
Questions?
But I mean, looks fairly positive, happy path type thing.
Oh, sure.
I'm sure you're building in.
Yeah, so there are certain things. So like an example would be, like on an airplane, if the airplane recognizes that there's some catastrophic failure, like it should alert the pilot. So the behavior is it should alert the pilot. All the different ways that could happen, those are all other tests. But the behavior of if there's a problem, flash a red light, like that's enough of a behavior. That you can talk about. You don't have to say when the landing gear won't come down, show the error. When this won't happen, show the error. When this doesn't happen, show the error. Those are all things that you can test elsewhere.
I see. Okay. And where would you test those others?
So I think those are things that would be perfect in your unit tests. It's hard though because most people